Hallelujah, thine the glory. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Revive us again.
This is Pastor Josh, here for your midweek message. And I want to talk today a little bit about revive us again. This week, our text is from Nehemiah chapter 8. We're talking about it on Sunday. And I know it got me thinking about, you know, what's going on with Nehemiah and Ezra. And Ezra he's found the Torah, it's been lost. But Nehemiah was cleaning up the temple, and they were fixing it up. And inside one of the broken walls, they have found an old manuscript of the Hebrew Bible, and they're reading it to the people. And the people start to realize how out of sync they are with God, how they need a revival, how they need to find a way to come back to God because they are far away. And it's not something we really talk about in the UCC, this idea of revival, this idea of coming back or repentance. We don't talk about that a whole lot. That's other Christian denominations. And I don't know that that's really smart. And I'm not saying that we need to have a revival as in, you know, the Baptist or Pentecostals. We need to have a big tent or have a, you know, five nights a week, have a special speaker. That's not what I'm talking about. What I am talking about is the spirit of revival. This idea that when we engage with the text, when we start reading the book and we start really trying to live by it, not the letter, but the spirit. Because we're not stoning our kids and we're not, you know, going to cut out cheeseburgers or no more shrimp. But there is a spirit, there is an undercurrent within the text that informs our lives, that helps us to be better people and to maintain a connection with God. It requires us to change. And that change helps us become better people. And by that, by becoming better people, in my belief, we have better lives. That, you know, Christ has come to save us from our sins, but also Christ came to save us from ourselves, that we are our own worst enemies, and that the mandates and the examples set by Christ for us help us leave ourselves, leave behind our selfishness and our own debased nature to try to live the way Christ would have us to live, to turn the other cheek, to love your neighbor as yourself, to reach out and care for the widows and the orphans. That these ideas of we could all be inwardly focused. We could all focus on what's mine and what's now and what's you know, easy to get. And society would crumble, to be really honest. We need the idea of helping one another and lifting each other up. And that is a part of this, and that's, I think, part of this idea of revival, that we need to focus on what is God wanting us to do? What is God calling us to be? That God is always, always calling out for us to do, calling for us to be better, calling for us to be more like Christ, and that no matter where you are in your journey with God, you can do more with that. You can grow in that aspect. And I think that that is our struggle right now, that we as people of faith, we need a revival. We need, at St. Paul, we need a revival. We need to revive and get back to those core tenets that God would have us do. So I hope that helps this week. I hope you feel revived and hope to see you on Sunday. God bless.
Who has shown us our Savior and scattered our night. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah, thine the glory. Revive us again.